We're here today at the Festival of Media LatAm in Miami. We're in the Fontainebleau Hotel. We're here in our M&M Global and Festival of Media pod. I'm here to interview our first speaker, which is Bob Bakish, the President and CEO of Viacom International Media Networks. Bob, what does it feel like to be at LATAM and to be one of our keynote speakers?
Hey, well, first, it's always great to be in Miami, and it's certainly great to be here at the Festival of Media LATAM. Look, Latin America is a very important set of markets for us. Clearly continues to be one of the growth markets of the world. It's one where we've been active for many years, and we continue to deepen our participation. So coming to the Festival of Media and making some remarks and being there for the crowd and the Q&A made a lot of sense to us.
And can you give us a kind of quick sneak preview? We don't want to give away too much of kind of what you'll be talking about and the topics you'll be covering.
Yeah, sure. I mean, I don't want to let you in too much because I'd have to kill you and then you'd have to throw away this video. But no, seriously. So we're talking about the world we're living in, and in that world, there are a number of constants that remain true. Things like content, continues to be king. There continues to be, real power in media and advertising. But to be fair, things have changed also. You have this explosion of interactivity and access that's, changing the way we distribute entertainment product, the way we market product, the way we do our events, and clearly the way we do marketing partnerships for all the advertisers and agencies in the room. So I'll be talking all about that, both from a conceptual level and then giving some examples.
So the key point we want to make, though, TV is alive and kicking, isn't it? It's just evolving and working out where it goes and how it distributes its content to its consumers.
Absolutely. People talk, and I was at the sessions yesterday for LAMAC, and they talked about the golden age of television. It is very much true. I mean, there's never been better content on air. There's never been a better time to be a fan. Because if you're a fan of, our Shores franchise, you not only get to watch the show on air, but before the seasons come up, we'll be doing Instagram photos of new cast members. We'll be tweeting about it. And so people really have the ability to get much more involved and, of course, continue to watch the episode. So it's a great time to be a fan of television. It's a great time to be a producer of original programming. And it's a great time for all our partners, including advertising agencies, to be involved with it.
And obviously yesterday you mentioned the LAMAC event, which was kind of an upfront event to see what was happening in the region over the next 6 months. What can we expect from Viacom over the next 6 months? Are you going to be changing some things around? Are you looking at new angles? What can we expect?
Well, look, at Viacom we're always moving forward. Probably the most exciting thing, there's two things that are going on. One is we brought our Shores franchise to Latin America in the form of Acapulco Shore. I'm going to talk a little bit about that today, and I'm happy to say the first episode got off to an extremely strong start. Our ratings were triple our averages, so we like that. But probably the biggest news is the launch of our Paramount Channel franchise here. That's really our fourth global brand, and it's already in a number of markets in Europe. It's in Russia, and we're bringing it to all of Latin America, both Spanish-speaking and Brazil. In November, and we'll launch with 10 million homes, which is mean trick.
Absolutely.
In this day and age, and we'll build from there. So we're very excited about that, and we'll show a little tape on that today too.
Wonderful. And how hard has it been to create the whole connectivity piece? So obviously we talked about the social aspect of things, so social media now obviously plays a huge role with Viacom, and then actually making sure that content is fit for iPads and all other devices. How difficult a transition has that been as a company?
Well, I think it's a transition that everybody, continues to be in the middle of. We've been focused on the multi-platform world for a while, and we certainly distribute our product on our linear networks. We have over-the-top deals. We do authenticated apps with distributors. So I'd say it's a lot of work, and there certainly is some trial and error. And again, when you look at how we bring new franchises to market, it's radically different than it used to be.
Yeah.
And you are working the social media, letting the fans get involved early, making sure they know about it. Because, these social medias are effectively the digital water coolers, they are effectively the EPGs, certainly for the younger audiences. And so you gotta do a lot of work and you gotta work it. But we have a model that's proving very effective, and I'm sure it will continue to evolve, but we're all over it.
Brilliant. And if you had to pick two or three key trends and insights that you think are going to be big in television in Latin America over the next kind of year or so, what would they be?
Well, you know, I think the first thing is we look for these markets to continue to grow. You know, pay TV, a lot of people talk about pay TV slowing down, and it's true that even in Latin America, it's not growing at the 20% plus that it has been, but it continues to grow. You know, subscribers are probably growing double digits, which is great, and the ad dollars continue to follow. So growth, I think, would be the first continuing trend. And then, as you say, you know, bringing new product to market. These are consumers that love to be entertained. They love brands. We're thrilled to be bringing our Paramount product to market, and we're also thrilled to be, you know, continuing to invest in our other brands, be it Nickelodeon, be it MTV, et cetera. You know, to your point on interactivity, one of the other things that we're doing is we're launching new networks in different forms. So we're launching this network, My Nick Jr., which is a virtual, personalized preschool channel where essentially your parents go in and define educational attributes they're interested in, might be creative exploration as an example, and then based on those parameters, the app goes against our Nick Jr. library and pulls out relevant episodes and plays them back automatically for your child. If the kid for some reason doesn't like an episode, they can indicate that, it'll skip it, it'll go to the next one. And if you realize, oh no, I gotta go out and get some milk, Your son can press pause on the television in the living room, pick up the tablet, get in the car, press play, and it picks up where it left off. So it's a really cool implementation, if you will, of Nick Jr. It's a reuse of the library. And I think you will, you know, people yesterday were talking about their various play applications.
Yes.
You will continue to see a lot of that worldwide and certainly in Latin America.
Wow, that's quite impressive. It's almost like a Spotify for television where it
creates
your playlist.
People have described it as that, and I think that is a good way for people to kind of get what it is. And let me tell you, it was developed by our French team, which shows you that great ideas can come from all over the place. And it launched with CanalSat, and their consumer research was off the charts. And so we took it, we said, that's it. That's going to be a global product. And even our U.S. colleagues rolled it out, like Verizon is rolling it out now.
Okay.
It's a very cool product.
Wow.
Very cool.
Yeah.
And it's coming to Latin America.
Fantastic, fantastic. And as we're here and there's lots of talent around us, yourself included, who will be speaking on stage, I suppose it brings me to the talent question and brands. How are you guys kind of involved in bringing talent to brands? How easy is that working with you guys? Are you finding that that's a great route to market in terms of advertising campaigns?
Right, so you know, we operate a portfolio of iconic brands, MTV, Nickelodeon, Comedy Central, and by the way, Comedy Central was really a US and European brand as recently as 2 years ago. Now it too is a global brand. It's in India, it's in Africa, it's in all of Latin America, et cetera. We're in Paramount. And then within those brands, we have these iconic characters. Some, you know, might be a SpongeBob, might be a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, but also as a place where, you know, talent can be used. So we work extensively with talent. You talked earlier about Isle of MTV.
Yes.
One of our great events under the MTV brand. And, you know, that's a place where we showcase talent. You know, I was recently at an MTV Push, which is our upcoming artist franchise. We did an MTV Push event in Helsinki, Finland, and there we showcased Charlie XCX. And if you haven't seen Charlie, she's fantastic.
Okay.
And that's an example of, you know, bringing talent to life through media, and also, of course, having advertisers involved in that. So it's a big part of the equation.
Wonderful, and I don't want to go on any longer because I know that you're almost going to be on stage. So I just want to say thank you very much for your time and good luck.
Anytime, a pleasure to be here in this very swank booth you have.
It's beautiful, isn't it?
Beautiful,
this is the state of art technology.
All right, man, thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.
Bye-bye.